Now, good morning cadets. Now, today I am going to teach you fractional order reaction. So, as I told study, order of reaction may be in the fractional also. So, just see the in fractional order reaction, some of the example I have given you. Basically, I have covered three examples. Just see. First one is the acetaldehyde, CH3CHO. That is equal to CH4 plus CO. So the experimental studies prove that even though in the chemical reaction we are writing one molecules of CH3CHO, but entire molecules of acetaldehyde or CH3CHO does not take part in the chemical reaction. Means their entire concentration does not decompose. It's only 3 by 2 parts is decomposed. So you know the order of reaction is experimental. It is the number of reacting species whose concentration changes during the course of chemical reaction. So since its 3 by 2 parts is only decomposing, that is why its order of reaction will be equal to 3 by 2 or equal to 1.5. Now second one reaction is H2 plus Br2, that is equal to 2HBr. So the rate will be equal to KH2, product of molar concentration of H2 and Br. Experimental studies prove that in chemical reaction I am writing one molecule of Br2, but experimental studies prove that it's only half molecules are taking part in the chemical reaction. So half molecules of Br2, so its overall with respect to H2, first order reaction. With respect to Br2, it is half order reaction. So total order of reaction would be 1 and 1 by 2, that is equal to 1.5. So just once again I am telling you that in fractional order of reaction will be in fractions. So third example is carbamate chloride, C. It is also known as phosgene. It is very poisonous gas. Always remember, there is a difference between CO and CO. This is cobalt. This is the symbol of cobalt. And this is carbon monoxide gas. So this is carbonyl chloride. It decomposed into CO plus Cl2. So its rate will be equal to CoCl2 and raised to the power 3 by 2. Why 3 by 2? Because experimental studies prove that its 3 by 2 parts is only decomposing. So its order of reaction will be 3 by 2 or 1.5. So in this way I have completed the order of reaction. So conclusion is, order of reaction may be equal to the stoichiometric coefficient of balanced chemical equation and may not be. So it is experimental. So while writing the order of reaction, we cannot predict on the basis of balanced chemical equation. So you should remember. Now examples of first order, second order, third order reaction I have given you. Even zero order reaction and fractional order reaction, everything I have completed. Now this is the time to teach you units of rate constant with respect to different order of reaction. Now, dear cadets, now units of rate constant K for zero order reaction. So, subsequently, I will teach you all its units of K for all order reaction. Now, I am beginning with the zero order reaction. So, zero order reaction, generally, I am writing like rate equal to K, and here A is the symbol of one of the reactant, and there concentration, zero order reaction does not depend upon the concentration of reactant. So here raised to the power I am writing zero. Means the meaning of this zero is A concentration does not affect the rate of reaction. So we can write here rate equal to K. And what is the unit of rate? Rate equal to mole liter inverse divided by time inverse. So here I am taking unit second. So this can be written like that also. The concentration concentration of reactant divided by time. So concentration of reactant is written in mole liter inverse and time unit is second. So the unit of rate will be equal to mole liter inverse second inverse. Now what is the unit of gain of energy or radiation? Here concentration means unit of A will not be taken because it is not taking part in the chemical reaction. So unit of K for zero order reaction is equal to K equal to mole liter inverse second inverse. That is the unit of K for zero order reaction. Once again, rate equal to K A. Here zero raised to power zero because the concentration for zero order reaction is zero only. Means for zero order reaction, the concentration of reacting species does not affect the rate of reaction. So we can write here rate equal to K. And what is the unit of rate? Mole liter inverse divided by second. And concentration rate means concentration of reactant or product with respect to the time. So the concentration of reactant unit is mole liter inverse. Time unit is second. So we can write here mole liter inverse second inverse. So for zero order reaction, K equal to mole liter inverse second inverse. That is for zero order reaction. So the unit of zero order reaction is, means unit of K for zero order reaction is mole liter inverse second inverse. Now cadets, units of rate constant for first order reaction. So the rate equal to K A. Here zero won't be there because it is not zero order reaction. It is the first order reaction. So what is the unit of rate? The unit of rate is mole liter inverse second inverse. Now K, and here what would be there? Mole liter inverse. That is the unit of concentration. So now K equal to what would be there? K equal to mole liter inverse second inverse divided by mole liter inverse. So the mole liter inverse will be cancelled out. Now the unit of K of the first order reaction is second inverse. Now unit of rate constant for second order reaction. So the for second order reaction, rate equal to K A raised to the power 2. So rate unit is mole liter inverse second inverse, that is equal to K. And here you should write what is the unit of A? Mole liter inverse. And here also mole liter inverse. Two times I am writing because two concentration is there. So the K equal to what is there? Mole liter inverse second inverse divided by mole liter inverse and mole liter inverse. So the mole liter inverse will be cancelled out. So what is the unit of this one? The unit of this one is liter mole inverse second inverse. Liter mole inverse second inverse. This is the unit of K for the second order reaction. Unit of K for second order reaction, you can write mole liter inverse second inverse also. You can write liter mole inverse second inverse also. There problem. Now unit of rate constant for third order reaction. Third order reaction means rate equal to K A raised to the power 3. Because third order means 3 reacting species should be there. So what is the unit of rate? The unit of rate is mole liter inverse second inverse. That is equal to K, and here 3 times you should write mole liter inverse. Again mole liter inverse. Again here mole liter inverse. So K equal to what is this? Mole liter inverse second inverse divided by mole liter inverse, here also mole liter inverse, here also mole liter inverse, bracket close. This also you can write. So now mole liter inverse is cancelled. Now here numerator only second inverse is left. So now what is the unit of this one? The unit of this one will be, can I write this side? Now the unit of this one is liter square. Now mole raised to the power 2. Now second inverse. This is the unit for K as far as third order reaction is concerned. So what is the unit of K for third order reaction is liter square mole raised to the power minus 2 second inverse. Dear cadets, in the same way we can calculate the order of reaction for any order of reaction. Means suppose it is nth order reaction. Then how you will do? So first of all you should write like that. Rate equal to K A raised to the power N. So what is the unit of rate? Mole liter inverse second inverse. And K equal to what is the unit of molar concentration of any reactive is, this is mole liter inverse. So this is raised to the power N. So now K equal to mole liter inverse second inverse divided by mole liter inverse now raised to the power N. Now of course this mole liter inverse will be cancelled out. So ultimately what would be the unit? Mole liter inverse 1 minus N. Very easily you can write, because 1 mole liter inverse will be cancelled out. So it depends upon N, how many number of N you have taken. So 1 minus N, here what is the meaning of N? Here the meaning of N is number of reacting species. So for nth order reaction, the unit of K will be mole liter inverse 1 minus N second inverse. Now question arises here. Suppose your reactive species is gaseous, then what would be the unit? If it is solid and liquid, so the concentration of reactive species is mole liter inverse. But suppose it is a gaseous species, then what is the concentration of gaseous reactant? The concentration of gaseous reactant is atmospheric pressure. So partial pressure. So here we will use short form, that is ATM, and we should express in terms of ATM. So I will not derive all those things. For gaseous reactant, I will write the unit for first order, second order and third order, even for the zero order also. What is their method of calculation? In the same way you can calculate, only the concentration of reactive species you should change, not concentration, unit of concentration you should change. Here the concentration unit of reactive species is mole liter inverse, there you should write ATM. Yes, so dear cadets, now units of rate constant for gaseous reactions. So just see, already I told you, wherever unit of reacting species you have written mole liter inverse, there you write the ATM. Now your units are ready. Just see, like for zero order reaction, if it is not gaseous species, so what the unit for first, means for zero order reaction? Mole liter inverse second inverse. So here in place of mole liter inverse, just you write ATM. Similarly for first order reaction, what was the unit? Second inverse. So concentration term was not involved, here also second inverse. For second order reaction, you have written mole liter inverse. Now write ATM. Your order of means unit of rate constant is ready. So wherever, once again I am telling you, wherever you have written mole liter inverse, there you write ATM. Now your unit is ready. Rate constant is ready. So in this way, your units of K for gaseous अपना समरी आया गिवन है। सो डियर कैडेट्स, नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक विद इन द सेम यूनिट दैट इज केमिकल काइनेटिक्स ओनली, मॉलिक्यूलरिटी ऑफ रिएक्शन। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय मॉलिक्यूलरिटी? मॉलिक्यूलरिटी इज नथिंग बट नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज, नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज। सो नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज मे बी एटम, मे बी मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड मे बी आयंस आल्सो। सो इट इन मोर प्रिसाइज वे वी कैन डिफाइन मॉलिक्यूलरिटी लाइक दिस। मॉलिक्यूलरिटी इज नंबर नथिंग बट नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज विच कोलाइड विद ईच अदर इन ऑर्डर टू ब्रिंग द प्रोडक्ट, इन ऑर्डर टू फॉर्म द प्रोडक्ट। सो इन ए सिंपल वर्ड, मॉलिक्यूलरिटी इज नथिंग बट ए नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज। सपोज इफ नंबर ऑफ रिएक्टिंग स्पीशीज इज 1, so its molecularity will be 1 or it will be called unimolecular reaction. If its molecularity is 2, so it will be called bimolecular reaction. If its molecularity is 3, it will be called trimolecular reaction. I will write the examples also, don't worry. So the simple thing is here, molecularity is nothing but a number of reacting species. So just try to understand, whenever we are writing the balanced chemical equation, so in any balanced chemical equation, the number of reacting species are clearly mentioned in terms of their stoichiometric coefficient. So what we can say, molecularity can be predicted on the basis of their stoichiometric coefficient, which is written in their balanced chemical equation. Why in case of order of reaction, what was there? In order of reaction cannot be predicted on the basis of balanced chemical equation. So that is the basic difference between order of reaction and molecularity. Order of reaction cannot be predicted on the basis of balanced chemical reaction, but molecularity can be predicted on the basis of balanced chemical equation. Yes. So now the definition of molecularity of reaction is written here. What is the molecularity? Molecularity is nothing but a number of reacting species which collide simultaneously to bring about a chemical reaction. Collide simultaneously. Remember, for the formation of product, all reacting species must collide with each other. If they are not colliding with each other, it means product is not formed. It means reaction is not going to over. So I will explain you this one in later on also, what is the importance of collision when reacting species are reacting with each other. Right now I have written here 4 reactions. Just see here, H2O2 that is equal to H2O plus half O2. How many number of reacting species are there? Only one reacting species is there, that is hydrogen peroxide. So what is its molecularity? Its molecularity will be 1. Here it is written. If molecularity is 1, so it can be called unimolecular reaction. Now in NH4 and O2 also, the number of reacting species is 1 only. That is why it is also unimolecular reaction. But here NO plus O3, that is equal to NO2 plus O2. Here number of reacting species is 2. 1 molecules of O3 and 1 molecules of NO. So its molecularity is equal to 2. So it is called bimolecular reaction. Now in reaction number this, 2NO plus O2. So what is the total number of reacting species here? The total number of reacting species is here 2 plus 1. 2 molecules of HO and 1 molecules of O2. So its molecularity will be 3 and it will be called trimolecular reaction. So always remember, generally bimolecular reactions are there. Only sometime trimolecular reactions are there, and after 3 molecules means 4 molecules, 5 molecules in the same reaction is not possible. Means molecularity must not increase from 3. Means in difficult condition only molecularity is obtained 3. Beyond 3 it is not possible. Why? beyond 3 molecularity is not possible because in the definition what is written, they simultaneously collide. Who collide? Reacting species. If the number of reacting species is 3 or more than 3, so it is not possible that simultaneously they will collide. Two may collide with each other, but what about third and fourth? And to bring about chemical change or to bring about the product formation, what is required? They must collide simultaneously. At a time only they should collide. If number of reacting species is 3 or more than 3, then what is there? They will not collide simultaneously. So the product formation chances are negligible. That is why molecularity never exceed 3 or beyond 3. 3 is the maximum limit for the molecularity. Beyond 3 molecules, molecularity won't be possible. Now, so I am writing here question answer. What is this one? Why is molecularity not increased beyond 3? So answer is written here. Simultaneous collision is not possible if more than 3 reacting species are there. That is why molecularity does not increase beyond 3. There are some reactions where the number of reacting species are more. You might have seen in 11th class that I have written so many reactions where the number of reacting species are 10 and 12. Here again I will write one other example. Then how those reactions are possible in the nature? There are so many reactions where the number of reacting species is 10, 12, 9, 8. But these reactions are taking place in the nature. These reactions are happening. How is it possible? If molecularity cannot increase beyond 3, I will tell you the answer. If number of reacting species is more than 3, so those reactions are not taking place in one step. Means if molecularity is beyond 3, so those reactions will not take place or will not happen in one step. They are taking place in more than one step. And in each step, the number of reacting species would be 2 only, maximum. Beyond 2 is not possible. And such type of reactions are called complex reaction. So now, on the basis of molecularity, there are two types of reactions. Number one is the simple reactions, second one is the complex reactions. In simple reaction, what is there? Molecule means one or two reacting species are taking part. While in complex reaction, more than 3 reacting species are taking part and entire reaction will not be occurred in one step. More than one step that reaction will occur. So now there are some basic problems here. In complex reaction case, what are those problems? Suppose if reacting species are 1 or 2, then the order of R, if any reaction is happening in one step, so the rate of reaction will depend on that step only. But if reaction is taking place in more than one step, then on which step order of reaction should depend, or in which step rate of reaction should depend? So for them, they have given, means scientists have given the solution. Means in case of complex reaction, if reaction is taking place in more than one step, so the slowest step will be the rate determining step. And more than one step if reaction is taking part, so in each step more than one or two reacting species should be there. More than two reacting species are not possible. So the remember, on the basis of molecularity, reactions are two types. What are those types? Simple reaction and complex reaction. What are simple reaction? Complex reaction. Simple reaction which take place in one step. Complex reaction which takes place in more than more than one step, but in each step the number of reacting species will not increase more than two. So this classification of reaction is on the basis of molecularity. I will explain this complex reaction in detail in next video. So today's class is almost over. Whatever I have told you, please write down all those things, and in one of the video I will give you some questions also. So those questions you should write and furnish to me or submit to me for checking also. I will give you the number also. Meantime, whatever portion is completed, just keep reviving. Afterwards I will give you some questions, don't worry. So to study the other subjects also, just keep focusing, keep concentrating on this one, because this is the only possible way to interact with you. And even if you have any personal problem or if you have got any problem with understanding the concept, personally also you can contact. Most of you are having my personal mobile number also. Thank you.